Hey everyone, this is Mary DeMuth and this is Pray Every Day, where I pray you through the Bible verse by verse. We're continuing our adventure through the book of Matthew, and we are in Matthew chapter 13, verses 10 through 13 in the New International Bible, and it says this, NIV. The disciples came to him and asked, "Why do you speak to people in parables?" He replied, "Because the knowledge of the secrets of the kingdom of heaven has been given to you, but not to them. Whoever has will be given more, and they will have an abundance. Whoever does not have, even what they have will be taken from them. This is why I speak to them in parables. Though seeing, they do not see. Though hearing, they do not hear or understand." Mind if I pray for you? Lord, I have puzzled about this. I have puzzled about why you speak in parables. But as I think about it, I see this as even an invitation into relationship. Because when someone tells a story that has a hidden meaning, it causes people to ask questions. It causes them to press in. It causes them to have a conundrum in their mind and they have to wrestle with it. And so this was part of your strategy to bring people to yourself, but also to bring them in relationship with you. Because later we see that the disciples asked, "What in the world does this mean?" And you explained it to them. And that was in the context of relationship. And so I just thank you right now that you are the relational God. You are the God who woos us. You are the God who leads us beside still waters. You are the God who speaks in parables. And you are the God of mystery. You are the God of story. You are the God of our stories. And so we just thank you for that today. We pray that we could find you in the middle of our story. Lord, I know one of the things that's been really helpful for me is just to write a timeline of what I have seen in my life over the years and how you have intersected that timeline. Sometimes it's hard to think about your faithfulness today because we're in the middle of it and we forget all about your faithfulness for whatever reason. We have this spiritual amnesia, but it's easier for us to look back and say, "Oh, now I understand, and that's why God did that, and this is why this happened here, and this is supernatural," and all of that. So, Lord, help us today just to spend a little bit of time with a piece of paper and a pencil or a pen and write down some of those milestones where we experienced your faithfulness, and we could look back and say, "Okay, yeah, God has been faithful in my story." And Lord, you are the hero of our story. We're not the hero of our story. We could never be the hero of our story because we're not all good. But you are all good and you are the hero of our story. So we love you for that. And help us to live in such a way that people would see you as the hero and not us as the hero. Help us to know what it means to take up our cross daily and follow you, to serve others with gladness, to serve you with joy, to lay down our lives for the sake of others, to lay down our lives before the cross. We want to learn what it means to surrender. And Lord, that's a hard word because so many times, if I'm really honest, I'm grabbing at control. I'm trying to control outcomes. And it's not easy when I'm living in that state because I'm really stressed out and my fists are clenched. But you have called us to open up our hands. You have called us to trust you enough with the story that you're writing in us to open our hands and let you pick out the things that we're tightly clinging to. Surrender is simply to say that you're in control and I'm not. You are God and I'm not. You are big and I am not. You are glorious and powerful and I am not. So Lord, we choose right now to surrender to you. All of our cares, all of our worries, all of our frettings, all of the difficult relationships, our worry over our physicality, our habits, our things that we've done wrong, the secret sins that we hide. We give you all of those things right now. And we thank you that right now we can experience your forgiveness, your lavish love, your tenderheartedness, your fatherly compassion toward us. And we can face today with a clean slate. I know I've prayed that before, but I just pray it again because I think we need to be reminded that you are not only faithful to us as we look at our timelines and see how you intersected them, but you are faithful to us today to forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness and to take all of our worries and cares because you care for us. So we joyfully surrender to you today in Jesus' name. Hey, thanks so much for listening to Pray Every Day. If you want to bless this podcast, you can share it with a friend. So in any way that you're listening to this, just share a button and spread the joy of people being listening to scripture, which is amazing, and then being prayed for. Some people don't know that they're being prayed for, and it'd be really great for them. Maybe there's someone out there who's a shut-in and they just don't have a lot of relationships and they need to know that someone's praying for them. Just pass this on to them today. Have an amazing day, and you are loved, my friend, from the top of your head to the bottom of your toes.